just arrived at tonight's location, which is Morecambe Winter Gardens. So as you can see behind me, the big picture house. So yeah, across one side of the road we've got the lovely seaside, and on the other side we've got this beautiful building that we'll be investigating tonight. Some of the most haunted crew, we've got Karl Beattie and Stuart Torville from Most Haunted. So yeah, we're really looking forward to this place. Can't wait to get started. So let's go in, yeah?
Yeah, let's go, mate.
Let's go.
I'll let you know when I find one.
Right, so these two skeptics are calling you liars. Is there anyone? I mean, we're going to be around on tonight. I think we just fucked off now. Sorry, you're probably aware I swear like a. But is there any questions anyone asks you and I? I mean, we are around the place, so Karen, ask us questions if you don't want to ask, but is there any questions you want to ask? Don't be afraid to ask anything yet.
Do you believe in ghosts?
I believe in ghosts.
Have you seen ghosts?
I think I'll be preaching not to. Because there's too many people around the world that have seen a ghost. And unless we call them liars, then they have to be ghosts. However, the fact of a ghost being a spirit of a dead person is only one explanation of many hundreds of explanations of what that ghost is. A ghost is a label we give something that we can't explain. Whether a door shut, we know there's nothing open, no windows open, and our ghost must have done it. It could have been a ghost, but it could have been our energy that's done it. Could it be, if we see something, could it be our own hypnagogic or hypnopompic sleep states? Could it be any other outside forces that are causing these things to happen for us to see it? It's the illusions of magnetic forces, etc., etc. I won't bore you, there's a huge fucking lecture with that thing behind it. But the spirits of a dead person is just one of many possibilities that a ghost is. But yes, also I do believe in ghosts.
Do you believe in ghosts? I do. And I'll tell you for why. I believe in them. You've probably seen anyway because I've had too much happen. How verify that? You guys as well. I've had things happen on the lives, on the live show, like, where was it, in Scotland? The Edinburgh Vaults.
Oh yeah,
yeah. There was a famous one there where my back got slashed.
Oh, yeah.
Those who had seen it.
And the brewery, when the barrel.
Green Gate Brewery, that's another one with the barrel rolling down. Yeah. And I was the other person on the side of the building, Carl and the rest of the team were over the way. Yeah. You know, these are little things, or big things, if you like, that I can't
explain.
You know, this place and say, oh, it's a figment of my imagination. You know, the slashes on my back, that really happened. You know, I had this coat and this exact coat with a white t-shirt on, standing next to the back of a wall, you know, and I think I might have been holding a cable or something for the cameraman, you know, and there was a few other people around me, whether there was someone on a mini camera going live, and I think it was two webcams in that room as well, you see, and all of a sudden I had a burning sensation on my back. And it was at that point when Yvette was talking, I like yelped out, if you like, a scream. She said, what's wrong? I said, I don't know. So it was just a burning sensation on my back. And if I remember rightly, I actually took my jacket off and Yvette lifted up my t-shirt. Yeah. And then I think she said, let's go from night vision into daytime, into colour. And she showed the torch on my back, and it was that point, because I couldn't see, I could only feel this. I could just feel the blood actually coming out of my back, and the viewers at home, bearing in mind this has been live fed over to America as well, I think there was a 3-second delay.
Did you really manage?
Yeah. You know, and they all saw it as well. You know, so something like that can't just happen out of the blue. Now, I got crucified on the show.
You're Jesus!
Because people were saying that I'd pre-done it, I'd planned it, or I scratched myself against the wall because there was an old wall made of old stone there, you see, and I couldn't possibly do that with this.
No, you had a camera for 20 minutes before.
Yeah, so nothing.
No damage to the top wall.
And believe it or not, I've still got the scars on my back, and I'm more than happy to show people later on. I've still got a problem.
How many times have you used that one?
Just to prove a point, that wasn't, you know, made up, and I've got full on my chest there as well. And Carl's got so much to say. But I could talk on that about various things that's happened, not just to me, but to other people as well. They're not there to stand up for themselves, but there's been so many things going on.
Yours are bigger though, aren't they, Carl? Yours are bigger than this.
Okay. Right, so what we're going to do then is split up into your groups and we'll go off. Literally, you're going to have about 45 minutes with each group. Please stick to that time. Right.
If anyone dies tonight, don't worry, we'll catch you on the next one.
In that room, just wait a second in there. Just watch this hole here. No one could really die on us on the first room. We'll leave that one for the second one.
Push it up twice.
Go what?
Push it up twice. Grab a seat, grab a seat.
Oh, my pocket. It's not on.
Push it twice.
Because there's so many of us here that's not met each other, we've got so many different energies, we can just kind of call out, see if we can hear anything, feel anything. And then once we've done that, we've got a table here, we can have a go at table tipping, we've got other rooms we can explore if we want to, we can do a couple of lone vigils if you want to do that as well. But just kind of just have a play with it and experiment, and obviously you've got Karl here as well that you can take off into a dark room.
Yeah, if anyone wants to go off, we'll meet at some point. Don't worry, I won't molest you in any way.
Just sign the contract.
Yeah. Now, if you want to go off, let me know, because I love this place. Absolutely love it.
This group, original one, you've got this room, you've got the room we've just walked through, you've got through there where the old swimming bath used to be, and through the other rooms that kind of run under Morecambe Winter Gardens. So we've got a lot of room to play at. We've got 45 minutes, so if anybody does want to have a wander while we're doing bits and bobs in here with Karl, have a bit of a play through there, then by all means, you can.
Okay. And just kind of really relax with it. We're all here for the same reason, even if we're, you know, some people more sceptical than others. Just try to relax and just let it flow. Just kind of accept everything that's around you. We'll question it as we go, which is what you have to do, but just really relax and accept.
You'll find
more open people around you as well.
I think Karl will agree, the more open you are, the more you kind of just relax with it and even have fun with it. The more time, you know, you're having a laugh, you joke, the more activity you will get. Just bear in mind there are other groups. Obviously, the group upstairs haven't settled down yet, so you will hear footsteps, so don't get excited.
You try and shut that out if you can. You know where that's sort of coming from.
Okay, if there's anybody here, if there's any spirits here at Morecambe Winter Gardens, we come with respect. Can you give us a knock, tap or a bang on something? Give these lovely guests a sign that you're here. There's a bit of movement down the other end, it sounds like on this floor, but there shouldn't be anybody. This is the group on this floor.
Is that the
And like I said, when we were doing the briefing, if anybody feels like they want to call out and have a go at it, by all means jump in there. If there are spirits here and they're standing back from us, it may be that they don't want to speak with a male person, it may be just my voice they don't want to connect with. You know, it could be a female, it could be one of you guys, it could be a family or friend that's come with you wanting to try and contact. So anybody just wants to jump in there, by all means do so. Come on, if you're here, please do something. We're here out of respect for you. We're not here to ridicule or harm you in any way. Please take the individual energies of everyone in this room and collectively use them. Please try to show us something. Either move something on the table, change the temperature. Please let us know you're here. If there's a personal message you want to give, please feel free to give it to any one of us. There's a few flashing lights. Coming behind where Mikey is with the red infrared camera, there's a couple of flashy lights where you can see the silhouette of Mikey. There's a couple of white flashing lights behind him. Are you making those flashing lights? If so, can you do it again? Can you sound like seagulls?
Yes. Result.
Very positive. Very positive. And you're good.
Would you show yourself for a lady?
You talk to me or a ghost?
I did say prove about the scar earlier.
Show that later.
Still waiting. Can you come forward, please?
There's somebody behind you then.
Yeah, absolutely.
I saw that.
If that was you making them footsteps, if you showed us a light over there, can you do that again for us, please?
People have about heads with torches and that, shouldn't they? The light's just come down the wall. Yeah. Can you make a sound over this side where myself and Carl are? Will come and affect us. Don't be afraid. Sure you've seen Carl before, have you? Can I say hello?
Was that a torchlight from above then, just over this? To my left.
It's trying to think, it's not used the term unnaturally quiet, it's just quiet, but it feels like distant. It feels, excuse me, undead. The air is dead, it feels undead.
It has dropped. It's really cold. It has dropped.
I think it's because we just sit.
Yeah.
What makes you feel like that
then? I think sometimes you just sense it. You know, from doing it for over years and years, you feel. I always describe it as a vibration. You can feel when something's going to happen. You almost sense when things are around, things are going to happen.
Yeah.
like I said in the briefing, it is all about experiment, and if it's not happening, then you try something else and try a different experiment. It may be that the spirit sort of connects better with all the tools. And,
and also, I think a lot of people, a lot of people have done a lot of these things know that you can spend hours in one place. I mean, while we're filming, quite often, you know, an hour's worth of television is actually 46 minutes because of the commercial breaks. You think, you know, we can have over a 24 period, we'll have 27 cameras running for 24 hours. So you can imagine how much footage is there. And we can be doing a seance for 3 or 4 hours and literally nothing will happen in some shoots, so we don't show that bit. But, you know, so people automatically, because everything's cut down, you can't have the reality of, you know, otherwise the show will be on for 24 hours. And that's the thing, it's that patience of just waiting and...
Thomas, when you're not looking for it.
Certainly yeah, exactly. Patience, yeah.
I did an investigation last week and we packed up, had a few little bits, and it was actually when we were getting in the car, I had a footstep, looked up and saw somebody walk past the car. Dressed in black, and I thought it was Michael. And when I turned the torch on to double check, there's no one there.
Well, there you go. You didn't take him home with you, did you?
I don't think so. Yeah, you could have brought him in.
Yeah. To try and get the energy down here, we'll use this table to try and float the table to it. Yeah? Just to try and get the energies going, see if we can get the spirits down here rather than everybody else. So you're going to squeeze in, and what you're going to do is just going to make contact, really, with the table. Try and get as many round as we can do. And what happened in the Victorian ages when they started doing seances, they found that tables started tipping one way or another, started shaking, rocking. You've seen it on Most Haunted, where they've sat around and the table starts moving, and sometimes the legs will lift up. And that's what we're doing. If there are a spirit here, then what they say is a spirit has to use energy to move anything. So we're the biggest source of energy here, really. So it will use our energy. Just by us touching the table, and we'll try and get it lifted or tipped or shaken or tapped in some way.
How easy is it to move? It's heavy, isn't it?
Yeah. Actually, if anyone was that side of the table, just put your hands under it, and then you just together you can see the energy that it's going to take to lift it. And that's what
Stuart was. Eight was around the table. So it's down hard. Okay, if you're not getting involved in it, what I would say is focus on the experiment, focus on the table, willing it to happen. And also, if you have got a torch, just do what I'm doing now and just focus on on these legs. Because while we're focusing on here and focusing on the experiment, we're not really paying notice to these. And sometimes we've been doing it and not realising that it's actually lifted off the floor. And because we're focused on here, we don't know what's happening underneath. Okay? Okay, if there are any spirits here, please come and see us, use our energies. See if you can give us a sign. Give us a knock, tap or a bang on the table. See if we can get the table moving in any way. We'll see if we can lift the table. See if we can lift one of the legs, or more if you can do.
Yeah, I don't know with anyone. You heard it, didn't you, Michael?
Yeah.
What was it?
I don't know.
Like a scratch.
Got something dropped over here, but there's nothing walking about.
Yeah, sounded like the top of a Smartie lid bin.
Yeah, it probably was like that.
Yeah, that's what it sounded like to me.
Keep going then. Use these energies, let's focus on the table. Can you do that again for us? It's slightly moved.
Did somebody move it then?
It does.
For everybody to have their hands on top of the table to literally physically move it, unless somebody's kicking it, is almost impossible. Yeah. Can you see if you can move it again for us, just ever so slightly? Can you do that again for us? Let's see if you can move the table for us, please. Come on, give us a clear sign. Move the table for us.
I had the leg moving on the floor.
Can you do that again for us?
That moved there quite heavily, that side.
Can you see if you can move the other side for us? Can you move the other side? Or move it the other way? Come on, give us a sign if you're here.
Oh,
I just saw a light go past my face. It may be from torch above, but it was very clear. It went straight past here.
I'm seeing the torch lamp. I didn't see anything.
Yeah, it was like it went in my eye. It just came in straight like this, so maybe it's from up there.
Can you tip the table? I know you're moving it. That's brilliant. Thank you very much. See if you can tip it for us.
Just a little bit more.
See if you can get this table off of the floor, just one of the legs.
Please. Would you please?
You can still hear it if you listen. You can hear the legs dragging.
Slight.
Yeah. Oh, thank you very much.
Wow.
Can you see if you do that again for us? That was brilliant, thank you. Keep it going.
Brilliant,
thank you.
You're doing
thank
brilliant,
you.
Come on.
I think she can't even see the legs move, they're
no.
just moving.
No, it's oh, just, yeah. I think it's a female. I think it's a female. Yeah, yeah,
let
you know we're here. Multitasking.
Right, must be a female, from, not from where I come from. Obviously, I'm not talking about my wife.
We're teller. You know that, don't you?
I know. I'm in trouble again.
You're in trouble.
But I'm always in trouble. It's just the amount of air.
Come on.
Come
try
on,
and
do
move
so
a bit
well.
More.
Wow. Well. Did you see that leg
well
there?
Look
at that leg there.
Well done.
That one there, it lifted, it really lifted.
Did it?
That one there, that
one's
shiny. Well, it properly lifted.
Did it?
Oh,
yeah.
Maybe we can see it moving.
It's moving.
Oh,
it's moving now.
Come on.
That's fantastic.
Do some more.
Yeah,
I
guess you can feel it.
Do some more.
That's fantastic.
Really?
Oh, thank you so much.
We've been here before.
It's strange because this one's not moving at all.
No, it's just that.
Yeah, this one's not. Yeah. This one, yeah. You do it again for us.
It's just.
Come on.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
Come on, big push. Brilliant.
Oh, wow.
It's off.
It's off. Oh, brilliant.
Well done. Well done. You're so clever.
You're so strong.
Yeah. Well, it's energy, isn't it?
It's brilliant. It's moving again.
Yeah,
can you lift it again for us? Use the energies.
Oh,
use the energies. Keep it going.
Come
keep
on,
it going.
Come on. You can do it.
Just that one.
This side's moving.
Slipping and that one.
Yep.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh.
That's just gone down now.
That was
amazing. You see how calm it is when it lifts up?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's fantastic.
That's fantastic.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Did any other legs lift up?
That one as well.
It's
ever so slightly.
Too far.
So from a scientific point of view, the only people that can be lifted now, this leg, which is
corner.
This on this corner,
yeah.
But they have to have their hands under it. They can't levitate it.
No.
For any of us to do it, we can't, laws of physics, we can't lift that
happen,
leg from here.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Come on, can we do it again, do you think?
Yeah, this one.
You can feel it getting.
Yeah.
Strong, and every time it lifts, you can feel it getting stronger and stronger.
Yeah.
And it seems like it's gone from that leg to
that
leg,
one.
To, that leg.
To this one as well now.
Yeah.
To that one as
well?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can I ask a question? Oh, one shut up, and then start me here.
Yeah, it must be a woman.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, can I say that?
Yeah, travel again. You said it out loud. Can we ask some questions?
You're going to ask.
If you move the table and say, if that's a yes, move the table, if you can. Please. You don't want us to ask any questions?
Ooh.
Oh, you do.
Oh.
Do you?
The legs seem to be moving
independently.
And the jolt.
That would have to be somebody going literally. Literally kicking or pushing.
Mm-hmm. Are you a male performer, perhaps?
This leg here is moving here. Yeah. That's a no.
That's a no on your side.
It's a female then. Possibly.
Well, we'll have to backtrack.
It could be those aliens.
Possibly.
Yeah, this is a theatre.
Or just a lovely.
Yeah.
Oh,
isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Oh, right.
Awesome. Yeah, lift his right up this side.
So that's a no. So you're a female then? You're a female and you performed here? In your day? You performed here, did you? That's a no.
No.
Okay, let's think of something else then.
You worked here, probably.
Maybe you worked here. Yeah.
No.
Stand
no to everything.
Okay.
There must be
a woman. Do you like playing games? Don't forget, my side is a yes, and Carl is a no. Well, somebody else has got to have some ideas then.
Didn't work here. Were you?
Have you followed someone here?
Yeah. Were you with someone that worked here?
Oh, yeah.
Oh my
God. Yes.
That's a
definite
no.
That's a no. Yes.
That's a definite no. Yeah.
I think it's
no. Somebody in this room.
Listed
on
this side. Yeah.
It's a definite no.
Do you know anyone in this room? Around this table.
Were you forced here? Against your will? Well, come on, darling. I know it's difficult, as Freud said. It's very difficult to understand a female, but we just need you to be... calm down. We... You didn't work here. You didn't know anyone that worked here, and you weren't forced here.
Move towards me then.
Yeah.
Towards me.
Were you here when the swimming pool was here?
I was just thinking that. Yes, it's probably. Is that a yes?
That might be a maybe.
Maybe.
Did you drown
here?
Came back again.
Did you drown?
No.
Did you take the money as people came in to have a bath?
That was more of a scrape than that.
Well,
the thing I actually love about this is because when it goes that way and that way, the only way it can do that is if two people independently working together to do it.
And
you just can't do it.
And no, you can't. They're not aware that it's going to move anywhere, are they?
Yeah. And the beauty of it is none of you guys knew what experiments we were going to be doing.
No.
So the only two people that knew what we were doing, even Carl didn't know what we were doing when we came down here.
Well, I don't know, really.
You know, even if I told him,
that's what my wife told me.
Well, listen to her.
Yeah. It's my wife, right?
Oh, wow.
Keep it going. Come on, last 5 minutes then.
How can that leg come up and that one not?
Well, it's twisted.
That's what I was thinking.
It's like sort of twisted.
Huh? See, this is one of the other things we've found, and I've got a theory, probably completely wrong, but sometimes when one type of activity happens, like the table moving,
when you ask them to do something else, it's almost like the energy is almost trapped in one thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it can't do something else, right. But it can do more of the same thing.
You've got to start the whole process again with building.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a lot freer.
Can you lift the table off the floor completely? We think this is absolutely fantastic. I can't tell you how much we appreciate it. And for whatever reason you were here, your secret is safe with us.
Well, and YouTube.
Okay, everyone's going to know you're
really, really moving.
You don't have to give us your name.
Goodness me.
Please.
We've been on some of these and this is...
We don't get many viewers.
No.
It'll be all right.
I know what you feel like.
Really good.
Use all of our energies around this table and try to lift that table if you can off the floor. We're not asking you to perform tricks. Floating one, but I don't know how it can. I don't know, it's obviously twisting somehow. But
you can see how the energy is built from one leg,
yeah.
Just moving slightly. And as we've got going and going and going, we've got almost a table moving.
It's amazing.
Yeah, these are the things, and I know we've obviously had time shows, but these are things. If you could sit here for another couple of hours, I'm sure this would lift.
Oh, yeah, it would. He's really wanting to.
Well, there we go. Look,
come on, keep going.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Keep
it
going.
Well done.
That's brilliant.
Oh,
well done.
Wow.
So good. I'm so impressed.
Thank you so much.
Oh, so good.
Please. Why are you so big here?
Is it weird how we actually we talk to them like children?
Mm.
But there's no other way to talk to them. It's bizarre.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Well, it could even be a charge, I don't know.
Just got a few minutes left before we go back around this side.
Well, we've got to have to
really big.
Yeah, to do something really good, and then we'll this is really good, but a little bit different, and then we'll leave you in peace, and maybe we'll come again another time and talk to you. Is that okay?
When we leave here, we'll still leave you with our energy.
Yeah.
So please tie into that. Thank you so much for what you've done this evening.
And stay with us.
Please do, yeah.
Good one.
No,
stay back to me and Carl. Stay here.
Now, I've done this loads of times, it's never worked, but hey, I can promise you a really great night, sweetheart. I say it.
He says that to all the girls.
I can never deliver.
It's still rumbling. Yeah, you feel it's still going. It's still rumbling.
Must be the woman, she's getting excited.
Yeah,
you keep it going.
You can't
go
not going with one finger, can you?
Just be quiet.
See if I can lift it on my own. It's on a kind of a wobble anyway, I think.
The whole table wasn't really moving, it was just like one leg. So.
Just press down,
see.
Just press down to one side.
It does kind of move,
actually. You've got to really want to sort of.
But when we have one finger on it, it's kind of moving, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything. Yeah. You're the second two. Yeah. We're obviously in the seats now. Possibly. Because the floor never.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. we going up now?
If
there's any spirits in this room, we ask you to come towards the table and move it for us.
That's it, build upon the energies around the table and draw in place there.
This glass won't hurt you in any way. It's just another form of communication. If you can come forward and move it, that'd be brilliant.
There's no chairs in there, so it's moving.
Is it because we've said that we're going into another room? Do you want us to stay in here? It is moving, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Come on, move the glass a bit more for us, please. It's like it's twisting.
Just
stop now.
Just no one was paying attention,
that's
right.
Yeah, true.
Gonna
just
do something.
Come on, we're gonna go. It's moving with just females.
Gonna leave this room.
Should we try with just females around?
You're in the toilet, Michael.
Perhaps they want the name to go. She's the ladies' toilet, so cool. Are you a lady?
Kind of feels like when there's less people touching,
it's vibrating slightly. That might just be moving.
Should we take it
in
the other room?
Yeah.
We haven't got chairs in the other room, so I'm going to go paper standing. It's a long room table, though.
Playing a ball of balls.
What's that? There he is under me in that. I just absolutely shit myself.
She did that. We've just left the room, right? She looked out and saw her own reflection.
I did! And the other one, I was looking at.
Reflection.
Oh, God. Oh, I'm drunk. I've done that before. Right, I'm moving away from that.
What one?
Yeah,
oh, your hair! No.
No. No. That was you. Did you move the glass for us?
What did you feel?
I don't like that. We'll try and move this glass. Like I said, no one's here to harm you, we just want to know if you're there. All these lovely ladies in the gentleman's toilets, eh?
Wonderful.
Yeah. Well, the guards will do some calling out. We could go into the middle room.
I'll go to the top, if that's all right.
We'll go to the top. It's your experiment, guys, so we can
do whatever you want.
Make a noise like that.
I heard that.
I heard that as well. Sounded like a budgie.
Heard that sort of.
It's from that end.
Can you do that again, please?
I heard the whistle from here.
Yeah.
Sounded like it was outside. It was in the distance somewhere.
It's kind of over there.
It's quite far away.
I know pointing, it's in the dark and you can't see where over
there. Yeah, I can see you, yeah.
Yeah, over there.
Yeah.
That was spirit whistling. Thank you very much. Please, can you do it again so we can all hear it?
I saw a shadow, and that's the first time I've seen anything.
Really?
Yeah. Like, and it frightened me. We was all walking down there, and I just saw this chair across there, and it was like that banged, and it did it twice. And I just turned around like that. Everyone heard the table move, but I think I was the only one that saw the shadow, and that's the first time I've seen.
That?
We was just walking up towards this room, and I just seen it shoot across that way, and then out
moved.
Yeah. And it just, and the table just banged. And I think there were people upstairs at the time, but it was at ground level. It was definitely.
What, just now?
Just a minute. Class off then if we're going to do some at the table. We have got the dowsing rods as well, so obviously we're aware that everyone can't fit around the table, so people can use the dowsing rods around the table as well if they want to.
It must be somebody there.
And then we can also. If people want to have a hand up, we've got obviously all this level here, around into the bar,
Is there
so I don't want you to feel like you're still staying in one group. It's a little bit more flexible here, but you can have one and do your own little things as well if you want to.
Okay. Stop now.
Have you seen something else?
It looks like it's coming towards us.
On the lot on the floor.
It was right back. Now it's coming a little bit.
It's moved actually, yeah.
Yeah.
There.
We
might
have
got
a spirit box, that's right.
Yeah.
Not
you saw it come in.
Stuart can kind of affect the phonics in it. And she makes up words, it's on phonetic mode. Hasn't gone off yet though.
So the lights don't mean anything when they're flashing, they always flash
over there. No, it's a bit like a K2 meter, it's still that it can affect the device and make up words. It's not said anything yet though, since it's been there.
Have you had that work then?
Yeah, we've had conversations with it.
Let me try this on FM. Going backwards at faster speed, the aerial down, and reduces radio noise as well if you put the aerial down. Okay, if there's any spirits in here, come forward, just going to use this device I've got in my hand. Can you come and give us a message through this? Don't be afraid, it won't hurt you in any way.
Is that a faint hello then?
Something.
Can you make it a little bit clearer, please? Come and use our energy if you need to. Don't be afraid, come forward. Come tell us your name if you can. Sometimes in different areas you might hear different. That's why we always record our live sessions, because you're not always going to hear it.
Someone talking over there. I heard female voices. Yeah, Alex, stand up for a minute. Yeah.
My God.
What screen is that?
Yeah.
That's not what I heard over there, though.
That was a proper
screen.
That was somebody. That was a guest screaming.
That was in pain. Yeah.
That was
a
funny scream. That was excited scream.
Is that from beyond the stage?
Yeah.
You know, I've got walkies.
No.
So it could be anywhere. Well, it's down at the stage.
It came from out that way.
That was a proper screen.
Yeah,
it was
a proper screen, yeah.
Stephen Hawkins.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Stephen Hawkins, that's it.
You see that?
Paul, yeah.
As we're walking up here.
Paul's in the room.
A spirit called Paul, possibly.
So if you're a male, can you give me a sign for yes? See, look, they're coming in together.
So let's see if it'll give you a sign for no, and see if it does go opposite.
So can you give me a sign for no? Opening up again, and I swear I'm not doing it.
So that must mean, so you've got your answer now.
Yeah,
obviously, it's crossing for yes, opening for no. So then, obviously, now you've got your yes and no,
and you've just gone together.
You can then, obviously, then start to ask your questions to confirm that it is a male spirit.
Did you act here on the stage? Did you work here?
Oh, it's staying open.
Yeah, it's doing nothing.
Have they come with somebody here?
Do you wish us harm?
Come on, show yourself. Move one of these seats. I'm sure you can do that.
Into the grand circle seating area, where the posh seats were. Just me and Michael for a minute. I'm going to try the spirit box. We've got to be quiet because everybody's in different areas and we don't want to make too much noise. The message now is just me and Michael. Can you tell us your name or... If you have a message, what do you want to tell us? Come and talk to us.
Go. Come out of here.
What's that? Male voice.
Male voice talking.
Is that a male voice? Is that a male spirit? Make it a bit clearer if you can. Hello. Hello.
Thanks. You're welcome.
Alex, this is Michael. I'm pleased to meet you. That's definitely hello, that sounds like me. But hello.
I think it may have even said it twice.
Got it turned down, obviously, as we just said, so I have to check back on some of these words. Hello again. Are we ignoring you?
Obviously, you may hear background noise, some other vigils going on around the theatre.
Yeah.
In the background of this video, at certain points throughout the night. As you can hear now.
We're doing table tipping by the sounds of it.
Yeah. It's really nice. Obviously, it's not
picking that up on that.
It's not controlled. Really?
Can you come near me, if that's possible, and make a sound?
Hearing this device? Screaming outside, well, not us. Definitely a gentleman here.
Is that? It's that. He is a gentleman, yeah?
Yeah.
Is he a gentleman?
I thought I said Harry or Gary. Who was screaming downstairs?
You might be in the main
closet. Who was screaming downstairs?
We were all screaming downstairs.
Screaming.
Yeah. Have you
someone
been down there yet?
Yeah, so
we've
got
that. First, we went there first.
They've said now it's darker.
We had flammers first and second time.
Yeah, it seems to have built up every time. What happened?
Just got a little scratch. My hand was flat on the table.
Nice. Put a normal vision on the ceiling. It's quite a bad scratch.
Mm.
Yeah, it's only a little thing. It was amazing downstairs.
So how did that happen? Yeah. Were you against the wall or something?
No, well,
we're all sat around the table. Hands on table.
No, I just felt something like pressed down on it.
And we were looking like a scratch
now.
Well, we could hear from at the top.
Yeah, we were up there, we heard screaming, yeah.
Well, the first time I turned around, someone was stood there, we didn't know, so we turned the lights on and scared the shit out of us. The table was running the incantation.
Oh, was it?
And the table was proper, yeah. Flying away. It was amazing. Anything happened at yours?
We've got a few things on the spirit box, didn't we?
Yeah.
We didn't get anything on the spirit box, it didn't work for us. We got
smell
smoke.
I can smell smoke on the top.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
We've seen red smoke we got down there.
It
just kind of floated around the room.
Just when we split off, we got the spirit box working, didn't it? It didn't work in the big group.
Yeah, that's what we did, the other group did.
Yeah. See, I think nothing happened in the circle.
That's where we just come from.
Yeah, that's where nothing happened.
The very top, we had nothing.
In there, behind me.
The next chair.
See, apparently, someone called Hazel was there, and Spirit Box came through with her name and told her to show up.
Today?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
I can't remember what she said.
They did get some stuff.
Yeah, we know.
No, it weren't in our group, it was a different group before us.
Yeah, we know who Hazel was.
Yeah, it came through with her name.
What group have you got next, Rose?
You've got a group.
Yeah. Yeah, if you want to, you can get going if you want to.
Good luck.
So are you screaming, Carl?
It was me screaming, yeah.
No
one else, it was just me collectively screaming all on my own. You see, this is all you need. A cup of tea.
The tea. Stop me screaming then.
I think my group's hopped off.
We're now heading down behind the stage with Stuart and his team. So let's go.
Very much on stage.
Something's just touched my hair, and it was just, I think it was either before or just after. I looked over there and I saw a figure walk by the door going from that way to that way, and I said to Pete, I said, I've just seen someone walk through the corridor. He said, well, everyone's here, everyone's in the room. I said, not here. I said, someone else, another member of crew or whoever, I said, I just walked by. He said, what did you see? I said, I just saw a figure walking by, but it was in black. Because from that distance, whoever stands there, you're not going to see any colour, it's just black, because you're so far away. And that's exactly what I saw. And Pete went out to have a look, couldn't see anything. I just squeezed the
had a hope.
No, I said she's going to get possessed now because Stuart's sat next to her.
Always happens to be for some reason. Hey, I'm never lucky. I'll just talk and talk. Oh boy, you just say so now. How are we doing? Now, if anyone feels anything at all, whether I'm talking or anyone else, just speak your mind and let us know what's going on. What we'll do first, I'll say my name out, and then we'll go from me to my left, and if we can all just introduce ourselves, and then I'll carry on talking. My name's Stuart.
My name's Michael.
I'm Christine.
I'm Pet.
Hello.
Margaret.
Sandra.
Helen.
Sue.
Kelsey.
Okay, to the spirits out there, now you know who we are. Could you please make yourself be known to us? We're sitting around the table, joining hands. If there are any spirits, good or bad, could you please make your presence be known to us now? We don't mean you any harm or any disrespect. We have to try and listen out very carefully as well.
Yeah.
We have to decipher any radio chatter to any other kind of chatter that might be coming through there as well. Could you please show us a sign that you are here?
Is that me?
It sounded like a man's voice.
Mm. Are you telling us that you're here now?
Can you tell us your name?
If you are here, please shake the table. Please communicate through this electrical device we have on the table. I am getting cold drafts around,
yeah,
and
I'm
cold, sure everyone else is as well. But there is that door with that gap, so that's possibly coming from that door. Could you please change the temperature on this stage? Could you please make it go a lot colder than what it is now? Please touch one of us on our shoulder. It sounded like it, didn't it?
Hello.
It's a fine line, really, isn't it?
Mm.
Between what's real coming out of that and what isn't. Stuart.
Come on, you're doing really well. Can you make it a bit clearer for us?
I'll ask one more time.
What?
I shall ask one more time. Can you please say my name clearly for everyone? Stuart.
Maybe the beginning wasn't as clear. But... if you're here, can you give us a message, please?
stay or leave? Yes or no? Are there any actors with us now who used to perform on this stage many years ago? If so, can you please say yes? Did you enjoy acting here? You did?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's getting really cold in here.
Yeah. That's the same, right? Is it your right arm?
My left.
Ah, that's the right arm there.
Are you here amongst us now, around this table? If so, could you please do something for us?
I am as well.
The smell meter just went up.
Yeah.
Michael, it's the first time it's changed.
Smell?
Male meter.
Right.
The EMF just went up on that. That's the first time it's gone off since we've been in here.
Be quiet.
My name's Stuart. Can you please say my name? Could you please say the name Kelsey? Do you like Kelsey? It did say Kelsey, didn't it?
Can you give us your answer then?
Is Kelsey wearing pink?
Yes.
Did it?
Yes.
Yes.
Did it say that?
Yes.
It sounded like
yeah. Yeah, I did. I like that.
If you just said Kelsey's name, can you repeat it, please?
That's a Richard.
Richard, Richard.
Is there anyone called Richard?
No.
Oh, I wonder if Richard.
It did sound like Richard, didn't it?
I thought you said not sure.
I heard it, but I didn't know it.
Damn it again.
You were cold.
Did you say Richard? Who is Richard? Are you called Richard? Is this your name? What do you think that said then? I thought it said Johnny.
Is your name Johnny?
Who is Richard?
Here. What? I said here. Is Richard here now, around this table?
Please help us.
Did someone just copy you then?
Thank you.
No, I just heard someone just say, please help us, after you asked that.
No?
I thought someone was taking a mickey out of Stuart. Heard on the headphones.
Please help us?
Yeah, after he said please help us, I heard someone say please help us, like that. I thought somebody was taking a piss.
Please help us. Can you please repeat my name, Stuart?
I'll ask one more time. Can you repeat my name for me, please? Stuart.
Do you have to bring your folder behind me? Here you go.
I'm Sue. Can you say Sue?
I'm not the Sue.
My name's Sandra. Can you repeat that, please? Hello?
That's like
this one. This one, you said?
This one?
This one.
Who's got it now?
What's your name?
It likes to have got it.
Try passing it round and asking it to tell us our name.
That's what we're doing.
That was the idea of it. Say your name in it, but I don't know if anyone's done it yet.
What's my name? What is my name?
Johnny.
No, it's my name. My name is not Johnny. Is that your name?
That was really fair.
Is that your name? Is Johnny your name?
Who's banging the floor?
Johnny. I'll
put it down.
Yeah.
Put it down there.
Can you tell me what my name is?
I know where it is now.
Huh?
Great.
What's my name? Can you tell me my name?
That's a seven.
Huh? It sounded like Agnes.
That's what I would do it.
My name's Chris. Does it sound like Chris? No, it sounded like Agnes. No.
I thought it said Michael, that's my name.
Oh, yeah.
As you were handed.
Go on then.
Can you repeat my name for me? Can you tell me my name?
Did that say Michael?
I thought it said Michael.
I was just thinking that though as well.
Mm. But because we want it to say Michael.
Yeah, that
don't
could be
we?
Why.
Then.
Yeah. Can you tell us what building we're in? I thought that said Morecambe, but that could be me wanting us to sound.
I thought that sounded like Morecambe.
I thought that's what that said.
What would you all do if that just suddenly stopped transmitting and said, fucking Morecambe?
That would be really good.
I was clearing down. Would you sit here or just run?
I really would love to hear it clearly down on there.
All right.
Really would. What was that?
Come on. Oh,
yeah, I said, come on. Yeah.
So
they want us to get on with
this.
Where are we going? Heaven.
Oh,
not yet.
Do
you want us to go? Tell us to go.
Are you still here with us, sir?
What the hell?
Oh, it's just right.
What was that?
Something behind me.
Oh,
I heard something dropped on the floor.
I heard something metal drop on the floor.
Yeah. It came from behind there.
I thought it was behind me.
I thought it was only that one.
Okay.
Did you hear something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
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 Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
What was that? Jesus
do that?
Has something been thrown or dropped?
Have you left us now? Did you get bored of us?
Pardon?
are you deaf?
Eh?
That was clear enough.
Can you whistle for us? Yeah, come on, whistle a song.
It did say pardon, didn't it?
It sounded.
Like
whistling?
Yeah.
Can
you whistle again? Can you whistle again?
No.
Please, come on, whistle again, we can hear you.
No. Of course it's okay.
Can you say one of our names then, if you can't whistle? We've all told you our names.
Are you going to stick around much longer, yes or no? If not, we are going to leave you. Do you want us to stick around, yes or no?
No.
That's hard anyway. Are you going to show yourself anytime soon? You could sit here all night and hear nothing, or you could sit here for an hour and have all kinds of things happen. It's just a look at the drawer, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's that? Because when it's on that level, it's only on each each radio station for 4 seconds. So if you get a word, that's like 4 or 5 stations.
Yeah.
In theory, you won't be able to. The probability actually get possible words together.
So anything we're hearing, we think might sound like what were the names we picked up earlier?
Johnny
and Richard. So that can't be from a radio station because it's in reverse mode, isn't it?
Well, it was when you were talking to Carlson and you said Richard, and I'd like Richard.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And you get trouble.
Well, it's just coincidence, isn't it? Of course. Mary loves Dick.
Why do you keep
up? Haven't you seen it?
Yes.
Classic, that is.
Well, that's our investigation at Morecambe Winter Gardens complete, and I thought it was an amazing night. Alex, what do you reckon?
Yeah, really good night. Great meeting up with some of the most haunted crew, Karl and Stuart. Lovely blokes, so yeah, cheers for having us. And what do you reckon then?
Yeah, it was great. Great meeting Lee and his team, and they put on a great show tonight. Activity, I think, in every area that we went to. Each group had different experiences.
Yeah, lots of screams. Had lots of screams from the
cellar. From what Karl was doing.
Yeah, a few of them ladies were screaming down there when Karl was down there. But I think they all made it out alive. But no, really, really good night. Public events always a hard one. This is probably one of the top ones we've been on, actually. Definitely recommend Most Haunted Paranormal Nights. I think they're going to do a few more.
So if you get a chance, get a ticket. Get on there.
We've got quite a bit of activity, so we'll have to check back on that.
Yeah.
Some stuff on the spirit box and the...
Hopefully it'll come through clear on the checking the footage.
Yeah, from the Grand Circle, that was the main area for that. And at the end there, possible EVP we'll have to check back on.
Yeah, be on the stage with Stuart. So, so hope you enjoyed the episode and get down to Morecambe.
See you later.
See you later.